What's up? It's Heit.
And Cheri. And today we're here to talk about Colin in Black and White, give our first thoughts on the miniseries, the short series. So in case you haven't seen it, this series is brought to us by Colin Kaepernick and Ava DuVernay. And it showcases Colin's time as a youth all the way up to when he goes to college and kind of his life experiences that lead to Colin Kaepernick that we know today.
Right. And it was available on Netflix. Yes. So that's how we saw it. We saw it on Netflix. At first, when I heard about it, I seen somebody post about it. Most of the time when people posting stuff on my social media feeds, I'm kind of like, yeah, I take it with a grain of salt. They were like, ooh, this is good. And I'm like, oh, man. You know, because you just never know. Even outside of that, I wouldn't expect that it would be good.
Right. It was better than I thought it would be. It really was. And it gave a lot of insight.
I thought it was pretty good. At first, I thought it was kind of weird that Colin Kaepernick, as himself, the grown guy, would come in at different points and have explanations and kind of talk like it's a documentary.
Well, in a way, it kind of was, right? It was the documentary without having him sit, you know, in the room with the black background and just be like, and then, you know, this happened. And
right.
That happened.
So if you don't know about the history of documentaries, you know how they have dramatizations. There was a long time ago, there was this one called Thin Blue Line.
Oh, yeah.
And they caught a lot of flack because they used reenactments or dramatizations in that documentary. And ever since then, we've been getting those. And if you watch the true crime stuff and all of that, mm-hmm. they're always doing dramatizations. So this can be looked at as a dramatization in a documentary.
Yeah, yeah. Because at the end of the day, it's Colin saying, in his own words, and approving what is being shown.
Right. And I really like, I came to like that aspect because we don't see things like that.
No.
And so when at first when you get it, it's like, man, what is this? This is stupid. And then when you get it and understand, then it's, you know, I see a lot of people are going to start doing this.
Yeah.
I think that's going to happen. I suggest people do.
I like it, though.
Yeah.
I really do. And, you know, one of the scenes that kind of sticks with me is where the periods of the series is when about his hair, you know, about him wanting to get braids and wanting to, you know, wear his hair in styles that his mom at one point in there says are like a thug.
Yeah.
You know,
because that was that whole thing that goes when Allen Iverson was, you know, in the NBA and, you know, kids wanted to be like him. He had the hair to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
And he had those adoptive parents.
Yeah. And that was something I didn't know. So I thought that Colin Kaepernick was biracial, which he may well be. I don't know all of his details, but I thought that was what I thought, you know. So I assumed that he had at least one white parent, but it never occurred to me that he had two white parents.
Right.
And that he had been adopted.
Yeah. And I don't think it was actually explained early on in the series.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, is this his mom with the new husband?
Right.
You know, I was confused
right.
at that point. Part of it was just there was this searching for mm-hmm. identity.
Yes.
That is and the backdrop with being an adopted kid.
Right.
Right. That he's searching for his identity and he is obviously black or a person of color.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So then navigating society, navigating social life as outside in the culture, but outside the culture, because we all know that black people gravitate towards each other when we're in these situations, right?
Right.
And somehow he just knew, you know what I'm saying?
And understanding that you, as a person of color, if your parents were white, you don't have the same privilege that they have. So maybe some of their privilege trickles down a little bit when you're with
yeah.
them. But just like we saw when he went to the camp and stuff the episode, you know, they were treating him one way and didn't recognize that these were his parents. And then when they
right.
did, it was like, oh, okay, you know,
yeah.
you get a pass.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes in these movies or these series or these TV shows, I wonder if they're doing it for the sake of being able to tell a story on the screen. Like, is it true that he was unaware for so long? Because it kind of seemed like he was unaware, but earlier in the series, it seemed like he really was aware of what was going on. You know, but yeah, the whole part about that privilege, you know, and not knowing, you know, how to act. I'm sure, like, not how to act, but how to be in this society, that his interactions with his friends and things that happened with his friends, I'm sure they let him know before this other baseball team of black players came along and said, they're treating you like this because you're black, basically.
Right, right. Mm, that's a good point. I think that maybe there's just levels of knowing, levels of becoming aware of who you are and your rank in society. And then when you don't have parents who can properly prepare you for what your rank is or who don't, then you kind of left to the wind, you know.
It kind of made me not like his parents, though, too.
I felt like
you
that.
You know, like early on, it's like we had to gain the love for them or appreciation for them because it was like, man, this cat parents is just blatant racist.
But you and know like, what's weird is that when his mom got him the hairstyle, you know, and let him get the braids and whatever, she was cool for a minute. But then in the next breath, it's like, you look like a thug. And,
yeah, I don't
you
know if it's bad writing or what, but it was very, it seemed contradicting. And it made me think, like, does he hate his mama? Like, when I first, in the first part of this series, I was like, dang, he must hate his parents.
I need to understand how you feel about your parents right now today. Like, because that was a real question after watching this documentary or, you know, dramatization, docu, drama, whatever.
Yeah, we need a new term for this.
Yes.
Ava DuVernay, you did it.
Another thing I wanted to point out was Jaden Michael, who plays Colin Kaepernick, the young, you know, plays him young. Excellent, excellent choice in actor. Like, I felt like it was Colin.
Yeah, the way he spoke. Like, he has a very distinct way he speaks. And so, what do you think? She's the language kind of, I don't know if it's called language, dialect. Expert, what do you like Colin Kaepernick himself? What kind of accent does he have?
It's hard to say.
Yeah,
it's like a mixture of different. Sometimes it's neutral, even, and then sometimes it's Midwest.
Yeah, so I was thinking like Midwest, and they were in California, and I'm like, I don't know what's going on here. You know,
very middle America.
And I'm like, accent. So did he get it from the biological portion? Because I'm like, the character, the actor who played him really nailed his accent.
He did. And just all around, just his whole vibe, he captured that well. I mean, that was a win. Like, y'all did that.
On YouTube, we actually took a poll from viewers of our channel. We asked, have you seen Colin in Black and White, the series about Colin Kaepernick that's on Netflix? Tell us what you thought of it in the comments. 57% of people who responded said yes, and it was great. 7% said yes, it was okay. And 36% says, haven't seen it and don't plan to.
So that's interesting.
Yeah.
Because why wouldn't you want to see it?
So I think part of the rift happened when Jay-Z came out and said, we're past that. And then it kind of caused a split. So people just like how we do now, we instantly take a side and start hating somebody. So now it's, and maybe with some little Ava DuVernay hate there
could
too.
Could be.
But I don't know. It's people don't like Colin Kaepernick and they like, I don't want to see anything about him.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
That's unfortunate. I mean, because whether I like him or not, actually, I would have still watched it. Yeah.
It's actual culture. Yeah. Like a lot of the stuff of, you know, the last few years of what has been going on is because of Colin Kaepernick. And it's our history. It's our culture.
He's advanced the conversation. Yes, you can't deny that part of it.
Yeah. Why wouldn't you want to know about these people who do this? That's what I don't understand.
And one of the things in that you understand is how badly he wanted to succeed in sports, you know, because he played baseball and he also played.
I think he played all three sports.
He played all the sports.
Yeah.
But so he seemed to have promise in more than one sport. And
supposedly was going to the MLBs, the Major League Baseball for as a professional and chose not to because he wanted to play quarterback.
Right.
Go figure. So, I know I would have just been like, just whatever's going to pay me, give it to me.
So, yeah. And to think that, you know, his career is just basically, you know, he's not playing now, hasn't been playing for some time, is rather tragic and unfortunate that, you know,
yeah,
he hadn't been picked up.
I find it a little sad and pathetic at times now, because every couple months, I believe something comes out and he's talking about, I'm ready, still training. And it's been so many years, you've sacrificed, right, and a lot has happened. And I think it's quite clear this isn't going to happen unless you go and play for some other league.
Yeah.
And it's kind of sad.
Yeah, it's real sad. Yeah. I wish it wasn't that way. So just want to take a quick second while we're having this conversation to say, please give us a thumbs up on this video and take a moment to subscribe. If you like this discussion and you like what we talk about when we talk about the new movies and the old movies and fan theories and all that stuff, subscribe. And if you don't like it, give it a thumbs down, but still subscribe so we can keep talking about it. So one of the things about the series is that I thought it would tell more of Colin's story. And I was a little disappointed that it ended where it did, like, right, you know, going into college and that.
Yeah. Me too. Because before watching it, I just figured it would be like, oh, this is going to tell a story of being in the NFL and stuff. But I guess it would be harder to tell that story because how much the NFL actually owns of his own story, you know, would be very difficult. And I don't know. After watching it, I don't think I want that as much now. I'm like, it's a very interesting story that you told.
Well, I don't want to make assumptions about what happened after that got, you know, like, I feel like I know the beginning. I'm missing the middle, you know, what happened in college, what happened after that leading up to, you know, when you started your activism in the NFL.
Yeah, we're missing that part.
I do want to know that.
Yeah.
But this was still great to know. Yeah.
But so without that, does it even matter? Should the story just be told about any other star athlete?
Sure.
You know, like, yeah, the only reason it was told is because it was Colin Kaepernick.
Yeah. But I would love to see more stories like this. I really like stories about athletes and what it takes.
Yeah.
We watch like Last Chance U and all of those kind of reality sort of shows where people are trying to make it in college ball and, you know, stuff like that. I really enjoy those shows.
Yeah. And I don't think this story. So the way I look at this story, you know how you mentioned, what do you call it? Being biracial in that sense, because I think it's still kind of that sort of story because he was in a white household.
Yeah.
So I don't think we get many stories like that. But when I do, when we do, I'm not really that interested in it. So I think they really did a good job at making it interesting and impactful. Like, because I could easily just be like, oh, here comes another one of these woe is me stories, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. In this case, he was a very sympathetic character. Yeah. Like, to see, you know, I felt bad for him because it's kind of like, and his braids was too tight in his head. And
they're always too tight. But also that part, I didn't understand. So he got his hair braided like every other black person. People, you black and you got your hair braided by somebody in the neighborhood. That's how it is. They braid your hair. And then it was they have to take him to a professional, you know, remember that was that
his
part?
Mama, though. She
but they basically went to the same place. You went to somebody else who braided his hair at their house.
Yeah, who said, come by the crib.
Yeah, but like, if you like, whoever braiding it is going to be tight. If the second one didn't braid it as tight or tight, then she probably didn't do a good job.
Oh my gosh, the tight braiding.
I can't do it myself, but that's just how it is.
Yeah. Reality of getting your hair braided.
And the time lapse kind of his hair. I think that was wrong. It wasn't done right. It's like he had the braids in for three whole seasons.
Maybe he wore the braids for...
Yeah, but they were saying it got fuzzy after... fall and spring or whatever.
How long did you have the braids in your head?
That was kind of unclear. But overall, it's pretty good.
So all in all, one of the things I'll also point out is that I feel like Colin made a lot of points about things that need to be said about race and experiences that people have that are not traditional experiences that people face, because he really was like at the intersection of, and not by his own doing, just of these different races and cultures and how difficult that must have been for him, you know?
Yeah. So do you think it's worth it to watch it or not?
Absolutely. You know what? My answer is always going to be yes.
Always?
When it's involving, you know, Black people.
Yeah. I think you should watch it. I don't know if there's anything that I'm just like, I'm definitely not watching that. There's probably things that I haven't watched.
Yeah.
And don't actively seek out, but there's nothing like, I'm definitely not watching that.
Well, what does it hurt to watch it? And like I said, even if you don't like him or whatever, sometimes you can get more information just by learning more about people and understanding a little bit more about their perspective and where they come from. Because really, that's all people really need and want. You know, you want to be understood and you want other people to understand. And how will we ever get that if we don't give it, you know? So that's my thought. But if you made it this far in the video, please type I care in the comments to let us know that you actually listened to everything that we had to say. Give us a thumbs up on the video, subscribe to the channel, or give us a thumbs down. Still subscribe to the channel so we can keep talking, and we'll see you next time.
Holla.
Bye.